Hello students, I welcome you for today's session. Now students, let's do a quick recap. In the last session, we did the chapter that is of Beehive, chapter 6, My Childhood. And I hope you understood the chapter and you've been able to complete your notes. Okay, now today we are going to start with your chapter of chapter 5 of Moments book. Okay, so I would like all of you to open up Moments book on page number 28, and this is chapter 5 that we have, and the name of the chapter is The Happy Prince. Now this is a very interesting a very touching story. In fact, it's a story about two friends. Okay students, and I hope you'll enjoy this chapter. Now as this chapter is lengthy, so I'll be dividing this chapter into two videos. So this is video 1, and in the video 2 we'll try to cover up the chapter. Okay, so I hope you are ready with your book on page 28. So let's begin reading the chapter. Now okay, so before we begin the chapter, so The Happy Prince, as the title goes, so it's about basically Happy Prince was once a prince of a place, of a I would say, yes, of a very good town, and the people of that place were very happy, and the prince, because the prince was very happy, and he made sure that the people were also happy. Okay, but now the prince is no more there, he's dead, and the statue of that prince is put up outside at the entrance of that place, of that city. But however, now the state of the people and the state of the place is very different. So this is what the story is all about, and there is one more character which I will introduce as we read the chapter. So the Happy Prince was a beautiful statue. He was covered with gold, he had sapphires for eyes, sapphires a kind of gems, and a ruby in his sword, rubies again a gem. And why did he want to part with all the gold that he had and his precious stones? So there comes a stage in the story where he wishes that he was not made of gold. He tried to use his gold that the statue was made of, the sapphires and the ruby, just for the goodness of the people. Okay, so let's begin the reading. High above the city, on a tall column, stood the statue of Happy Prince. He was gilded. Gilded means, यहाँ पे gilded का मतलब होता है सजाया हुआ था. Okay, the statue was decorated all over with thin leaves of fine gold. So the whole statue was covered with gold. For eyes, he had two bright sapphires, and a large red ruby glowed in his on his sword hilt. Hilt means the place where you hold the sword, उस जगह पे जहाँ पे हम sword को पकड़ते हैं, वहाँ पे एक ruby का diamond था. Okay. One night there flew over the city a little swallow. His friends had gone away to Egypt 6 weeks before. Before he had stayed behind, but he had stayed behind. Then he decided to go to Egypt too. Now swallow is the next character, students. So it's basically these two characters the story is based on, the statue of the Happy Prince and the swallow. Swallow is basically a small bird, small white color bird. It resembles the goose. Okay, and this bird usually goes away to warm places, migrates to warm places, as it cannot tolerate the winter season. So now what happens is, one night a swallow was flying over that city, and it wanted to go to Egypt. Now his friends had gone and he wanted to take some rest. Okay, all day long he flew, and at night time he arrived at the city. "Where shall I put up?" he said. "I hope the town has made preparations." So the swallow is talking to himself, and it's trying to say that I hope there is some place to stay in the city for the birds. Then he saw the statue on a tall column. "I will put up there," he cried. "It is a fine position with plenty of fresh air." So he aligned just between the feet of the Happy Prince. So finally swallow ko ek jagah mil gayi thi Happy Prince ke दोनों पैरों के बीच में. सो वहाँ पे उसको लगा दैट ही वुड बी प्रोटेक्टेड. आई हैव अ गोल्डन बेडरूम ही सेड सॉफ्टली टू हिमसेल्फ एज ही लुक्ड राउंड. ओके सो वी कंप्लीटिंग द फर्स्ट पेज एंड वील गो टू द नेक्स्ट पेज नाउ. So now the swallow is talking to itself and it is very happy because it says that I have a golden bedroom because the happy prince statue is made of gold. So he looked around and prepared to go to sleep. But just as he was putting his head under his wing, a large drop of water fell on him. What a curious thing, he cried. सो क्या होता है, अचानक से उसके ऊपर एक पानी की बूंद गिरती है एंड ही फील्स कि पता नहीं कहाँ से ये आ गया, पानी कहाँ से आ गया. सो ही ट्राइज टू लुक अराउंड हियर एंड देयर. देयर इज़ नॉट अ सिंगल क्लाउड इन द स्काई. द स्टार्स आर क्वाइट क्लियर एंड ब्राइट एंड येट इट इज़ रेनिंग. देन अनदर ड्रॉप फेल. वॉट इज़ द यूज़ ऑफ द स्टैचू इफ़ इट कैन नॉट कीप द रेन ऑफ. सो The swallow is talking to itself that I have not found a good place because it is not protecting me from the rain, he said. I must look for a good chimney pot, and he determined to fly away. So the swallow started searching for another place that is near, maybe inside the chimney, so that he can stay warm also. But just he was about to fly, but before he had opened his wings, a third drop fell and he looked up and saw. Ah, what did he see? The eyes of the happy prince were filled with tears and tears were running down his golden cheeks. His face was so beautiful in the moonlight that the little swallow was filled with pity. So what he came to know is that the statue of the happy prince was crying. Who are you? He said. I am the happy prince. Why are you weeping then? So the swallow says, he asks, and the statue replies that I am the happy prince. So this is ironical. Ironical ka matlab hota hai students opposite. Ki ek taraf wo keh raha hai ki wo happy hai aur dusri taraf se wo ro raha hai. So this is what the swallow asks. Ki tum ro kyun rahe ho? You have quite drenched me. Drenched ka matlab hota hai bhigo diya hai, bhig gila kar diya hai usko apne aansuon se. When I was alive and had a human heart, answered the statue, I did not know what tears were, for I lived in the palace where sorrow is not allowed to enter. My courtiers called me, Happy Prince. Courtiers means the people who worked for him in the palace, okay, called me the Happy Prince, and happy indeed I was. So I lived and so I died. So the happy prince statue says कि मैं बहुत खुश होता था, मेरे जो courtiers थे, the people who worked for me, even they call me happy. And मैंने पूरी अपनी life happiness में बिताई है and I died happy. And now that I am dead, they have set me up here so high that I can see the ugliness and all the misery of my city. And though my heart is made of lead, yet I cannot choose but weep. So, ab happy prince keh raha hai that yes, now I have been put up here at the height of the whole city, and I can see how sad and how my city is and people are very unhappy. And though my heart is, I'm made of lead statue. And my heart is also of lead, but still I feel sad, and that's why I cry. What is he not a solid gold? Said the swallow to himself. He was too polite to make any personal remarks. Far away, continued the statue, in a low musical voice. Far away, in a little street, there is a poor house. One of the windows is open. And through it, I can see a woman seated at a table. So the happy prince is describing one of the situation of his city that is making him cry. वो क्या देख रहा है कि दूर एक बहुत दूर एक घर है and that is a very poor house and there is a lady who is seated at a table. Her face is thin and worn. Worn means tired. And she has coarse red hands all pricked by needle. फॉर शी इज़ अ सीम स्ट्रेस. सो वो जो लेडी है शी सीम स्ट्रेस इज़ बेसिकली अ पर्सन हु स्टिचेस क्लोथ्स. ओके एंड स्पेशली फॉर द रॉयल फैमिलीज. एंड शी इज़ टायर्ड एंड शी इज़ नॉट फीलिंग वेल एंड उसके जो हाथ हैं दे आर ऑल प्रिक्ड. प्रिक्ड का मतलब है छिल गए हैं नीडल की वजह से. शी इज़ एम्ब्रॉयडरिंग फ्लावर्स ऑन द सैटन गाउन फॉर द लवलीस्ट ऑफ द क्वीन्स मेड ऑफ ऑनर टू वेयर एट द नेक्स्ट कोर्ट बॉल. सो वो एक ड्रेस तैयार कर रही है क्वीन के लिए, क्वीन्स की मेड, क्वीन, यस, क्वीन की किसी फ्रेंड के लिए जो मेड ऑफ ऑनर होने वाली है. एंड जो उसने नेक्स्ट कोर्ट बॉल मीन्स टू द नेक्स्ट रॉयल पार्टी में उसने पहननी है. इन अ बेड इन अ कॉर्नर, इन अ बेड इन द कॉर्नर ऑफ द रूम हर लिटल बॉय इज़ लाइंग इल. उसका एक बच्चा है वो बीमार है. ही हैज़ फीवर एंड ही इज़ आस्किंग हिज मदर टू गिव हिम ऑरेंजेस. हिज मदर हैज़ नथिंग टू गिव हिम बट रिवर वाटर. So he is crying, swallow, swallow, little swallow, will you not bring her the ruby out of my sword hilt? My feet are fastened to this pedestal and I cannot move. So ye sara scene jo hai, sad scene jo hai, wo happy prince us swallow ko describe karta hai aur end mein use kehta hai ke I'm very sad. एंड उसे रिक्वेस्ट करता है कि स्वेलो लिटिल स्वेलो, क्या तुम मेरी स्वॉर्ड से, तलवार में से एक जो रूबी है वो निकाल के उसको दे के आ सकती हो उस लेडी को. मेरे पैर यहाँ पे फिक्स्ड हैं बिकॉज वो स्टैचू है. ऑन द पेडेस्टल मीन्स ऑन द प्लेटफॉर्म जहाँ पे स्टैचू खड़ा किया हुआ है और मैं नहीं मूव कर सकता हूँ. सो कैन यू प्लीज़ डू दिस फेवर. So yes students, now we are going over to the next page, page number 30. I am waited for in Egypt, said the swallow. My friends are flying up and down the Nile and talking to a large lotus flowers. Soon they will go to sleep. So ab swallow keh raha hai ki mere to jo friends hain wo Egypt mein mera wait kar rahe hain and wo river Nile se guzar rahe hain. एंड वो मेरी वेट कर रहे होंगे तो मुझे वहाँ जाना पड़ेगा. ओके सो द प्रिंस आस्क द स्वेलो टू स्टे विद हिम फॉर वन नाइट एंड बी हिज मैसेंजर. द बॉय इज़ सो थर्स्टी एंड द मदर इज़ सो सैड, ही सेड. सो प्रिंस कहता है, रिक्वेस्ट करता है कि प्लीज़ एक दिन के लिए मेरे पास, एक रात के लिए मेरे पास रुक जाओ. वो जो बच्चा है वो बहुत बीमार है और उसकी मदर कुछ नहीं कर पा रही है. So I don't think I like boys, answered the swallow. I want to go to Egypt. So yahan pe swallow is trying to escape itself. It does not want to, it's not really in the mood of helping the prince. But the prince looked so sad that the little swallow was sorry. It is very cold here, he said. But he agreed to stay with him for one night and be his messenger. So finally, looking at the sadness, sad face of the prince, the swallow decides that, okay, he will stay and it will try to help the happy prince. Thank you, little swallow, said the prince. The swallow picked out the great ruby from the prince's sword and flew away with it in his beak over the roofs of the town. सो फाइनली स्वेलो वो जो रूबी है उसकी तलवार के तलवार में से निकालता है और अपनी चोंच में उसे लेके पूरे टाउन के ऊपर से फ्लाई करके जा रहा है उस लेडी के घर. ही पास्ड बाय द कैथीड्रल टावर वेयर द वाइट मार्बल एंजल्स वर स्कल्पचर्ड. नाउ यस स्टूडेंट, सो कैथीड्रल ओवर हियर, कैथीड्रल इज बेसिकली अ चर्च. ओके एंड वहाँ चर्च के ऊपर जब वो उस सिटी से गुजर रहा है, सो ही पासेस बाय, ही क्रॉसेस द चर्च एंड चर्च के ऊपर वाइट मार्बल की एंजल्स बनी हुई हैं. ही पास्ड बाय द पैलेस एंड हर्ड द साउंड ऑफ द डांसिंग, साउंड ऑफ डांसिंग. अ ब्यूटिफुल गर्ल केम आउट ऑन द बालकनी विद हर लवर. आई होप माई ड्रेस विल बी रेडी इन टाइम फॉर द स्टेट बॉल, शी सेड. I have ordered flowers to be embroidered on it, but the seamstresses are so lazy. He passed over the river and saw. So वहाँ पे when he is passing by, he even goes over the palace, and palace के ऊपर से it sees दैट यस वहाँ पे जो क्वीन है वो बता रही है अपने लवर को दैट शी इज़ गेटिंग हर ड्रेस रेडी एंड जो सेम स्ट्रेसेस हैं दे आर वेरी लेजी. ही पास्ड ओवर द रिवर एंड सॉ द लैंटर्न्स हैंगिंग ऑन द मास्ट ऑफ द शिप. सो व्हेन ही वाज पासिंग ओवर द रिवर द स्वैलो वाज पासिंग बाय सो इट सॉ लैंटर्न्स हैंगिंग ऑन द मास्ट. नाउ मास्ट स्टूडेंट्स हियर इज बेसिकली द लॉन्ग पोल दैट इज ऑन द शिप्स and it is its basic purpose is to hold the cloth which is used to you know it is opened and then when it is windy and in the stormy situations so they use it as giving directions to the ship. Okay, so that is basically a long pole. At last he came to the poor woman's house and looked in. The boy was tossing feverishly on his bed. टॉसिंग फीवरिशली ऑन इज बेड का मतलब ये है कि वो बुखार के मारे तड़प रहा था अपने बेड के ऊपर. एंड द मदर हैड फॉलन अस्लीप शी वॉज सो टायर्ड. इन ही हॉप्ड एंड देन लेड द ग्रेट रूबी ऑन द टेबल बिसाइड द वुमेन्स थिम्बल. नाउ थिम्बल यहाँ पे स्टूडेंट्स थिम्बल इज़ अ काइंड ऑफ स्मॉल कैप दैट इज टू बी वोर्न ऑन द फिंगर. It is basically used by the people who have to do work with the needle, especially embroidery, so that their fingers are not hurt. Okay, so it's basically a cover. Then he flew gently round the bed, fanning the boy's forehead with his wings. How cool I feel, said the boy. I must be getting better. And he sank into a delicious slumber. सो उस स्वेलो ने क्या किया, वो धीरे से उस लड़के के पास जाती है, अपनी विंग्स से उसने उसको हवा देने की कोशिश की. द बॉय फेल्ट अ लिटिल कंफर्टेबल एंड ही वेंट ही सैंक इनटू डिलिशियस स्लम्बर का मतलब है ही वेंट इनटू अ वेरी डीप एंड साउंड स्लीप. देन द स्वेलो फ्लू बैक टू द हैप्पी प्रिंस एंड टोल्ड वॉट ही हैड डन. इट इज़ क्यूरियस ही रिमार्क्ड बट आई फील क्वाइट वार्म नाउ although it is so cold. This is because you have done a good action, said the prince. And the little swallow began to think and then sleep. Thinking always made him sleepy. So even the swallow is feeling very happy now. When day broke, he flew down to the river and had bath. Tonight I go to Egypt, said swallow. And he was in high. So we're going to the next chapter, next page students, page number 31. So what happens yahan pe, jab wo wapas aata hai, so he tells the prince that I feel it is very cold, but I'm feeling very warm. So prince usse kehta hai, yes, tum aisa isliye feel kar rahe ho, because you have done a good thing, okay? And so then the bird says, okay, today he goes to the river, takes bath and he announces that yes, aaj main wapas chala jaunga Egypt. So let's go over to page 31. So said swallow, and he was in high spirits. He was in high spirits at the prospect. Iska matlab ye hai that he had fully decided. To be in high spirits means to be fully encouraged and to feel very confident. He visited all the monuments and sat a long time on the top of the church steeple. Now, steeple yahan pe again, that means the cross that is on the church. Okay. When the moon rose, he flew back to the happy prince. Have you any commissions for Egypt? He cried. I am just starting. So, wo happy prince ko bolta hai ki yes, kya tumhe koi message pass on karna hai Egypt mein? क्योंकि मैं अपनी जर्नी इजिप्ट के लिए तैयार शुरू करने वाला हूँ. स्वेलो स्वेलो लिटिल स्वेलो सेड द प्रिंस विल यू स्टे विद मी वन नाइट लॉन्गर आई एम वेटेड फॉर इन इजिप्ट आंसर द स्वेलो. स्वेलो स्वेलो लिटिल स्वेलो सेड द प्रिंस फार अवे अक्रॉस द सिटी आई सी अ यंग मैन इन अ गैरेट. इन अ गैरेट, नाउ गैरेट हियर मीन्स इट्स अ वेरी स्मॉल रूम which is made on top of the house, like it is basically used kind of a storeroom ki tarah hota hai ye. He is leaning over a desk with papers and in the glass by his side there is a bunch of withered violets. सो अब यहाँ पे जब वो स्वैलो अपनी जर्नी शुरू करना चाहता है, फिर से प्रिंस उसको रिक्वेस्ट करता है और उसको रोक लेता है, और वो एक और सिचुएशन बताता है जो उसे परेशान कर रही है. सो ही सेज दैट येस, वहाँ पे एक एक यंग आदमी है, वो अपने कमरे में बैठा है एंड उसके एंड वो टेबल पे उसने अपना सर रखा हुआ है. उस टेबल पे कुछ वायलेट्स, दीज आर फ्लावर्स, ओके. तो एक ग्लास है, उसमें सूखे हुए फूल हैं. हिज हेयर इज़ ब्राउन एंड क्रिस्प एंड हिज लिप्स आर रेड एज पोमोग्रेनेट. सो द लिप्स आर बींग कम्पेयर्ड विद दी पोमोग्रेनेट. आई होप यू नो वॉट इज इट. इट इज़ लाइक अनार, जिसे हम कहते हैं, ओके. एंड ही हैज़ अ लार्ज एंड ड्रीमी आइज. ही इज़ ट्राइंग टू फिनिश अ प्ले फॉर द डायरेक्टर ऑफ द थिएटर, बट ही इज टू कोल्ड टू राइट एनी मोर. देर इज नो फायर इन द ग्रेट. नो फायर इन द ग्रेट का मतलब, स्टूडेंट्स, यहाँ पे है कि फॉरेन कंट्रीज़ में वहाँ पे एक फायर हाउस, एक फायर प्लेस बना होता है घरों के अंदर, ओके. सो ग्रेट का मतलब होता है दैट आई वुड से दैट प्लेस जहाँ पे वुड्स रखी जाती हैं एंड दे लाइट द फायर. सो दैट प्लेस इज़ कॉल्ड द ग्रेट. सो हैप्पी प्रिंस कह रहा है कि वहाँ पे ग्रेट के अंदर बिल्कुल फायर भी नहीं है. एंड हंगर हैज़ मेड हिम फेंट. आई विल वेट विद यू वन नाइट लॉन्गर, सेड द स्वैलो, हु इज़ रियली है who really had a good heart. He asked if he should take another ruby to the young playwright. So Swallow samajh gaya and Swallow was ready to help again. So Swallow said, okay, I will wait one more night and do you want me to give him the ruby? So the prince says, alas, I have no ruby now, said the prince. Okay students, I'll end up the video one here. Now join me back and we will carry on the chapter from this page only, page number 31, okay.